Stop moving. They can't see you.
Thank you. us, you idiot! Everyone breaks at some point, Sol.
We know your daughter's at the Cove. We want to go there. Tell us before Lutheran kills you. And if he does, we're all screwed.
You're gonna find it sometime, Sol. When I get my hands on your girl, oh, it's gonna be fun.
I don't think it's really safe to keep the fire.
Really? I've had it going for a couple days now. You know, it's an essential part for a civilized society.
Well, it's also a way for the wanderers to find us. And it's how I found you. I've been watching you for 2 days. You're definitely pretty careless.
This is uncomfortable. Were you watching me this morning?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't remember it being particularly cold, but you seem to be having a pretty good time.
All right. Well, I guess it's time for bed. We'll keep the fire on for now, but I will just take sleep shifts. Civilized world or not, I'm still a gentleman, so you can sleep first.
Sounds good to me. I haven't had a good night's sleep in days.
What's your plan in all this? Are you going somewhere? Or are you just trying to survive?
Put the fire.
Tell us how to get to the Cove. You aren't used to us. Just feed you to our little friend here. Tick. Top. Tick. Top. Tick. Top.
Untie him. I said untie him.
We'll find her, Solomon. And when I do,
tell me about the new world.
It's beautiful from what I've been told. Green, beautiful water, clean, non-toxic food. The fish are living and growing again. They even have vegetables. And it's run by healthy people. The survivors, like us.
place sounds amazing.
The oil refineries are opening back up, which means the government is rebuilding. And I am never trusting the government again. So the people at the Cove seem like my kind of people.
Are you sure they're like us? I've met some new people who weren't infected. They're not. They're scary.
You really want to know what I think? Fear of other people is what got us in this whole mess in the first place.
Let's find a boat.
That's the plan.
Pirates are going to get the best of us one day, Sam.
Yeah, well, that's the way I want to go, Solomon. See, I figure I got options. Starve to death. Eaten by a creature. Have them damn pirates hang me out to dry. Or I could just stroke myself until I die.
Oh, God, Sam. That is a horrible option. And a horrible thought.
I got no more family. Likely seen enough of this life. Hell, probably should have been gone 10 years earlier. At least you got that daughter. You know, one day she's gonna want to see her daddy. She's just been through a lot. Well, I thank you for the drink. Figure it's the least you could do for me saving your life. Again. You know, you're the only friend I had all these years, ever since this started. Die tonight?
Sam, you're not dying anytime soon.
Yeah. No. That remains to be seen. But you gotta stop being so stubborn. You gotta go see that girl. You did the right thing. You don't want to die all drunk like me.
Of course, AK-12s and 47s are all I have left, dude. Yes. I can't spend my money fast enough. Look, now with the government failing, I'm having a hard time keeping militia groups like yours fed. Really? Wow, you guys really hungry for the strongest stuff, huh? Hey, my son is calling. I better grab him. Yeah. Tomorrow. Luther! So nice to hear from you. Good. Good. Well, what? No, the world is not what it used to be, pal. But I'm making lots of money. Yeah, how are you? California with all the crazies. Yeah? Are they still taking away all your rights every goddamn day? Really? Please don't tell me you're wearing a mask to eat in restaurants. Seriously, they're all closed? Well, what's anybody gonna do to make money? That's gonna get crazy, son. I see mild violence in your future. Yes, with weapons provided by your daddy. I'm really glad you called. I've missed you.
Did you just put me on speaker? You sound weird. What's going on?
Well, a friend of mine just walked in. You remember? Captain Ben Solomon.
Ben Solomon? Solomon? Whoa, Ted, what the hell's going on? What the fuck is Ben Solomon doing there?
Can I offer you a drink, Ben?
What is going on? What the hell is going on in there?
Not like you to turn in a drink.
Still on the clock for one more minute.
So I got a minute. Luther?
Yeah, Dad?
I love you, son.
Luther, say goodbye to your father.
Wait. What is going on?
Thank you.
how are you so seasoned in all this shit? I mean, I've been dealing with this just as long as you have.
Well, a tough upbringing, many bad relationships, amongst a list of other things. Well, there used to be a list. Now I'm just a loner, killing anyone who gets near me. Except you. I will let you live.
Thanks. I appreciate that.
It's really quite amazing out here, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't think I ever really appreciated this for what it was. And now we can't even go in the water.
Why not?
The toxins? Not to mention the sea lions.
Sea lions?
Yeah. They ate all the dead fish and got this weird type of mad cow disease. What's worse is the people that ate the dead fish. They also call them sea lions. They're like the creatures, but they only exist in the water.
It's like God's taking his wrath out on us all at once.
God. Oh my God, you believe in God? That's a good one.
There.
Stuff, buddy. I got stuff. Look at this.
I think you're getting close, my friend.
So do I. As soon as we get her running, we'll be able to get out there and get fresh fish so easy.
You are so stupid. Get the boat running so you can get to the cove. Get the hell out of here. Make peace with your daughter. Find yourself a new woman. That's what I'm telling you.
Before I go, I forgot I made a fresh batch. Enjoy.
You are so good to me. Hey, be careful.
I will.
Sight for sore eyes.
You waited for you my entire life.
Leave her alone.
What makes you think he's even talking about her, you scraggly little bitch, huh?
You do realize you have to get through me to get to my daughter.
An eye for an eye.
What are you doing? You burning her?
This will just keep the wanderers from devouring her. Come down here. It's not safe up there. You can stay tonight, but after we bury your girlfriend tomorrow, you have to leave.
She wasn't my girlfriend.
Sister?
She was just a friend.
It doesn't really matter who she was. The point is, you can't stay here. You're not my kid, and you're not my responsibility. I'm going to bed. I suggest you go to bed too. Get some sleep.
Cody, what did you do today?
Absolutely nothing.
Shane, what did you do?
Same as...
Good. You did nothing. Good. Good. Dolph, what did you do?
Practice throwing knives all day.
Very, very good. Why didn't you practice throwing knives? Comes very useful. God damn it, feels like I'm surrounded by the fucking village people in here. Well, gentlemen... It would seem that more and more people are making their way to our little piece of the world.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Because it's utopia here.
Utopia. Is it utopia here, Dolph?
Yeah.
With their magical rainbows and unicorns that give BJs here? No?
No.
No, there's not. This place is a roaring fire of shit. Do you smell that right now? You know what the smell of that is? That is the smell of shit and rotting flesh. Because that is the only thing that this motherfucking marina fucking has. If you looked up shit in the dictionary, first off, it would be a picture of you, Shane, but right next to it would be a picture of this fucking marina. More importantly, the refinery is opening back up. You know what that means?
What?
It means that the fucking government is coming back.
Yeah.
Party's over, because there's a lot of them, and there's only 5 of us.
Look, we need to get to the Cove, and we need to get there fast.
Not to mention, if that girl was a friend of Solomon's, he ain't gonna let us off so easy.
I'm not sure I liked your tone just there, Shane. Because it sounded to me like you're implying that I should be worried about Solomon. Is that what you were implying?
I am suggesting that perhaps we should all be concerned about Solomon, yes. Could be trouble.
Could be trouble. Let me tell you something. I'm not worried about fucking Chewbacca with his goddamn crossbow playing around on his boat. That doesn't concern me, Shane. Do you think that it should concern me? Huh?
I want to be concerned is all I'm saying.
Oh yeah, let's go be concerned. Let's go stop at his boat and go steal some of his vegetables so he can't have a salad tomorrow. No, fuck you guys.
If I can find you some string, we can make her a proper cross.
Now this stuff's fine.
Are you sure?
She didn't believe in God.
Well, finish up here, and then I want to get you to the boat so you can pack up.
Who are the guys that attacked us?
They were soldiers, and then they became the resistance. They were the equivalent of what you'd remember as bad cops, the kind of guys who would shoot first and then ask questions later. I was one of them. We were hired by the government, and we worked under the CIA. It's back in the time when we used to work together to try to survive. Then they got greedy. They left their morals behind.
How many are they?
There's about 5 more of them left. And I would guess about 30 million wanderers.
Well, where are the rest of the good guys then? How many soldiers do you have?
Well, you're looking at 50% of my men.
Oh, shit. Our odds don't look that great.
That's because you haven't met the other 50% of my men.
Your usage of math and comedy are horrible.
I didn't ask you to come here.
Well, don't you think it would be better, you know, if I stayed here and helped? You know, we could, like, join forces or something.
No. From what I've seen so far, you'd just be another mouth to feed. I wish you'd stop following me.
I have nowhere else to go.
It's not my problem.
Why are you such an asshole?
Why are you such a little baby? Because everything in your life's been handed to you? Because you can't Google your way out of this? Look, I'm really sorry about what happened to your friend, but you're not my responsibility. Go find your family.
My family's dead. I have no one else.
Not my problem.
Can I please stay with you?
That is a good way to get yourself killed.
Look at me. I don't eat much. You know, I'm gonna die out there. I can barely defend myself.
Look, I just don't see any advantages of keeping you around. In fact, if I do, you're just gonna be an easy target for Luther.
Yeah, that sucks.
Look, just keep walking. I'm sure you'll run into friendly people sooner or later.
You can't just leave me for the wolves here.
I'm not. You came here on your own. I just don't want you staying with me. You're a handicap. Actually, I've got an idea. You ever use one of these?
Yeah.
I'm gonna let you use it. Come on, help me get this out of here.
So did you and that girl have some sort of plan?
Yeah. We wanted to get to the ocean, find a boat, go to this place called the Cove.
The Miraculous Cove. Place with all the young, healthy people.
You know about it? Is this just what you do all day?
Pretty much. But today's Tuesday. We're actually gonna do some entertaining. What's so funny?
How do you just know what day it is? Why would that even matter?
It's very important to run a calendar. Plus, I wanna invite you so that you can meet your new roommate.
Taco Tuesday, baby!
Sam, this is CAIRO. CAIRO, this is my friend Sam.
Shake my hand like a goddamn man, will you?
CAIRO, we've got much bigger fish to fry than worrying about Sam's germs.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah. So, what's your deal, kid? You just passing through, or are you lost?
Say both. Now I know where I'm going. Friend and I are trying to find the boat, though. Get to the Cove.
Ah. That's a place with those healthy young people. Well, can't say as how I blame you. I don't blame you. Take this idiot with you.
Here we go again.
What? What is it?
This old man doesn't have any friends, so I don't know why he always wants me to leave. Besides, Sam, if I leave, who's gonna take care of you?
His daughter's at the Cove, and apparently she's one of the gatekeepers, second behind the Queen Bee.
Oh my God. Why the hell would you stay here?
I don't have a boat that can make the trip.
You and I both know you can get a boat running in a matter of days.
Let's just drop it and eat.
Wow. Are you trying to show off for the kid? This is really good.
Why, thank you.
Here's some new friends.
I can tell you one thing. You're lucky he found you.
Yeah, I'd be dead for sure. I assume you know him?
Yeah. Yeah. Solomon led them, and I led Solomon. There was one psycho, his name is Luther.
Yeah, killed my friend.
Yeah, it was in the recent past. Seems so long ago. Some of them, they just got too evil. They did some really bad things. They abused their power. Yeah. Uncle Sam gets in contact with Solomon. Solomon takes out Luther's father, James Kurtzman. Solomon, he probably killed 30 of them. In self-defense. About half as many as I did, but who's counting? So now we coexist as best we can. For now. I'm thinking you probably need a place to stay.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you can crash at my place till you figure out what's best for you. I know Solomon's gonna need some solitude.
Why is that?
Well, like I said, he killed a good 30 of them that I seen with my own eyes. And, he thought by now he'd be retired, living in the Keys with his wife and his daughter. And he killed his wife. And it changed him.
What the hell?
He didn't murder her. She got infected. He had no choice. If he didn't kill her, she'd attack him and Amber.
Amber's his daughter?
Yeah. She didn't take it too well. She left and said she never wanted to see him again. Then she met others and they've been at the Cove ever since. That's what we've been hearing anyway.
Thanks for letting them crash with you, Sam.
Shit, Solomon. You almost gave me a heart attack. Yes, I'd be happy to host him until you get the boat fixed and take him to the Cove.
Not happening. I want you two to get out of here so I can get some rest.
Sounds good to me. Taco Tuesdays without any tacos always gets me really drunk.
Get him out of here before he passes out and you both end up staying here. It's the last thing I need.
Taco Tuesday. Oh, God. Get in here. Light these candles. Pretty good, huh? Oh, God. How does my head hurt?
Do you want to live? Deal. I'm gonna make you a deal with four options. Are you ready to hear option one? Option one. We blow your brains out right now. Bam! Well, there is a third option. Take the gun. Yep, there we go. Take it. Just point it that way. Third option is you shoot one of us. Me or that guy. It's risky, you know? Maybe we die. And again, maybe we don't. What happens then? Well, my guess would be that whoever doesn't die between me and this guy here, he'd probably be pretty upset. Probably gonna torture you more vividly and creatively than anything you could ever imagine. There is a fourth option, though.
Just shit over with so we can go.
Option four, it's a little complicated. It comes with a condition or two. You take this gun here. Hold it with both hands. Yeah, that's good. You take this gun. You march off this boat. You go down the dock. And you find Solomon's boat. And you walk up to Mr. Solomon, you point your gun at the back of his curly, bushy head, and you go, yeah. Oh, wait, I got ahead of myself. No, before you shoot Solomon, it's really, really important. In fact, it's super fucking important that you find out where the goddamn Cove is, because for some fucking reason, that imbecile knows where the Cove is, and no one else does! So, please, just find out from him where the Cove is, because, well, the thing is, me and my friends really want to go. You know what I mean? So, you find out where the Cove is, and then you shoot him, and then, well, you come back here to meet us. We'll give you one day. Yeah, that'll be enough time. Say, let's meet back here. It's time tomorrow. Okay? It's gonna be great. You're gonna come back, you're gonna tell us where the Cove is, and we're gonna take you there. On a magical fucking dolphin, we're gonna go to the Cove! I think he's got it. Alright, so I'm gonna give you the gun now and I'm gonna leave, but don't shoot me because we already talked about option three and that can get a little weird. There you go. Just gonna nestle it right in there. There we go. Yep. Don't put your finger on the booger trigger. Yeah, just, yep, there we go. Okay. Is that lavender?
Oh, just one thing. The last man that betrayed me. I ate him. So, don't betray us. Okay, Cupcake? Bye-bye now.
Sam. out.
Why didn't you come get me?
It all happened so fast. Luther ambushed us. Strangled Sam. Luther just let me live.
You couldn't have helped him. I knew I should have made you guys stay with me. He had way too much to drink. You're fucking useless. They attacked me, too. They must have been watching us. There was only one, but he climbed aboard right after you guys left, and I killed him. I knew they would come on strong sooner or later. This is something I can't fix.
I gotta get the fuck out of here.
And go where?
Anywhere. The Cove. Like Sam said, go and start a new life.
This is my life, CAIRO. I'm fine here.
But you're fine here. There's nothing here. Nothing. You can't fight everyone. Someone will beat you eventually.
If I'm not mistaken, there's only four pirates left. Luther and three others. So I think my odds of surviving are pretty good.
More wanderers come down here every day. The virus is spreading and you can't kill 30 million wanderers and sea lions. The government, they're just gonna throw you into a camp. You've been way too exposed living out here. And the refinery is almost fully operational. Sooner or later, your little harbor is gonna get overrun.
No, I'm not going to the Cove. Come on, help me get him.
Thank you.
You want something to eat?
Fine, thanks. Wouldn't want to use up all your stuff.
Okay, suit yourself.
Whatever anger you were feeling has been replaced by shame. Go to him. Something you can never get back this time.
Thank you.
Now am I just another mouth to feed?
Looks like he just became 50% of the rest of my men.
God, you really love your math jokes, don't you?
Where the hell did you get that gun?
I just Googled, where can I find a gun? And bam. I saved your fucking life, old man. But it only came with one bullet.
That's okay. It's a 9mm. Maybe Sam had some hidden on his boat.
If he had bullets, we would have found him by now.
You ready for a one-way trip to the Cove?
Do I look ready? Hell yeah.
At this point, I think it's the only way I'm gonna get you out of my hair. Let's go. Leave after sunset when the winds die down.
Roger that, Captain.
It's flatter, and we'll get more mileage. There's no way we're gonna make it with the amount of gas we have.
Do you think we could paddle the rest of the way?
We won't really have any other choice, unless they spot us and send a boat to come tow us in. By my estimation, we'll probably make it till about the 11-hour mark. Then we'll be out of gas, and we'll have to start paddling. But if everything's in our favor, we might actually make it. Also, keep in mind, CAIRO, I have no idea what's outside the harbor. Once we get to a certain distance, there could be bad weather, there could be more pirates, but at least there won't be any sea lions. I'm going to teach you how to use the coordinates and this compass in case something happens to me. That way you can keep going. You see this?
Mm-hmm.
This is the direction we're facing. We're gonna go at 180 degrees for at least half our trip. Probably, I'm guessing tomorrow when the sun comes up, we're gonna probably switch over to 200.
This is a sign, CAIRO. This is God's way of saying that my daughter doesn't want to see me.
That's bullshit, and you know it. Okay? We'll find another boat. We'll fix it up. We'll get more parts. I'll find more gas.
It is exhausting how naive you are. Sam was the mechanic. I just got lucky.
Saul, we can do it. Come on.
Just leave. Just leave. Go find another boat and start rowing. I showed you how to use that compass. You can get there in probably a day or two. I'll hold off Luther as long as I can. But I gotta stay here. Just go. Go!
I told you to go. You don't need me.
Oh. But I do need you. You know, Solomon, when I was a kid, doctors, they told me that I exhibit moderate sociopathic tendencies. Not so moderate anymore, huh? They said that my problem was that I don't care about people. But that's not true, you see. There was one person that I cared about, and you took him away from me!
I was just doing my job, Luther! Your father was not a good man!
Captain Benjamin Solomon? Or you're right to the Cove?
Dad. Dad!
Thank you.